Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about residential mortgage loans and its characteristics. Now, as you know, residential mortgage loans are the loans which are backed by residential houses or any such property which the borrower has purchased. So the transaction is quite simple, but you need to know a lot of things. In front of you is a diagram. So this is a bank and this is a borrower. Borrower gets a loan amount and in turn it will keep the property purchase as collateral. If the borrower does not repay the bank, then bank can attach this property. Attach means that it can take this property into its possession and it can sell it and recover the money. For residential mortgage loans, bank lends money to buy a property and the borrower or the home buyer keeps the home as collateral. If borrower defaults, then the bank takes possession of the home and sells it to recover the loan amount. This process is known as foreclosure. ये जो default होता है जब bank ये घर ले लेता है और बेच देता है, this is all known as foreclosure. Remember this term, we will study it ahead also. Now let's talk about some ratios that the banks will calculate. Banks calculate LTV. Banks will calculate loan to value ratio. Loan to value, as the name suggests, loan divided by value. Value of that collateral asset. Now, loan given divided by value of home is the formula. Tell me one thing, if you are a bank, if you gave a loan of $1 million, and house value, that collateral house ka value is $2 million. Is it good for you? Someone has kept their house worth $2 million as collateral against a loan of only $1 million. So now if this customer defaults, bank gets the house which is worth $2 million. Matlab 1 million ka loan deke 2 million ka ghar girvi rakha hai. So for banks, lower LTV is really safe. So first point, if you are a bank or if you are a lender, lower LTV should be preferred. Let's talk about one more example. Loan given is 10 million, home value is 15 million. It means LTV is less than 1. Now in this case, again, 10 million ka loan hai and home value is 15 million. LTV is less than 1. In this case, borrower has higher equity. That is, borrower will lose more if he defaults. And of course, bank is at a lower risk. Kya bolte isko? Borrower has higher equity. Higher equity matlab, if the house is worth 15 million, we can break it up into two parts. 10 million bank loan ke through aaya, 5 million kidhar se aaya? Using own funds. And that is why we say that if you are using your own funds, you have higher equity because you have a higher chance to lose that. Ye jo 5 million jo tha na, ab wo bhi chala jayega along with that house. So if you default on this loan and if you've kept this house as collateral, bank gets the whole of your house. So borrower has higher equity, higher chance to lose. Ye jo 5 million dala tha, ab wo bhi chala jayega. If LTV is 2, next case, if LTV is 2, of course bank is at risk. How? Agar loan hai $20 million ka aur value of collateral hai sirf 10 million, ye jo house hai uska value kitna hai ab? Only $10 million. If you default, then 10 million ka jo house hai wo bank ka ho jayega. But bank will lose out on the other 10 million. So in this case, if the LTV is more, then bank is at a risk. Types of residential mortgage loans. There are two types of loans, prime loans and subprime loans. Prime loans means good loans. Subprime loans means little bad loans. Three categories. Pehla hai credit quality of the borrower. You can see in the center, credit quality of the borrower. Prime loans mein it will be higher because these are good loans. So jo borrowers hai, those are very good. So credit quality of the borrower is higher for prime loans, lower for subprime loans. Lien on property. What do you mean by lien? Secured. If someone says, I have a first lien on your property, then someone says, I have a second lien on the property. What does lien mean here? Let's check. First lien, $1 million. Second, $2 million. There is one house which is collateral with two banks. Bank A and Bank B. Bank A has kept the first lien. Bank B has second lien. Both are secured loans, definitely. But jo Bank A hai, it has the first right over this house. Bank B jo hai, uske paas second right hai over this house. Basically, one house is collateral against two bank loans. Dono bank ke paas collateral ek hi house hai. But first lien wala jo bank hai na, that will get its money first by selling that house if the borrower defaults. Phir jo paisa bacha, that will go to the second lien owner. So, if it is a prime loan, of course it is a good loan, toh first lien hoga. Subprime hai, toh definitely it will be second lien. Last factor is risk to the bank. Of course, if prime loans are good, lower risk to the bank. And subprime are bad loans, so higher risk to the bank. Characteristics of residential mortgage loans are as follows. So there are five characteristics: maturity, interest rate, amortization schedule, prepayment options, and foreclosure. We will be studying each and every point. Now let's talk about the first characteristic, which is maturity. Now, typical tenure of these loans is 15 to 30 years in the USA. In the United States, it is 15 to 30. Even in India, it is close to 15 to 30 years. Europe, it is 20 to 40 years. France and Spain, it is up to 50 years. And in Japan, you will find maturity of residential mortgage loans up to 100 years also. So basically, two or three generations will be repaying this loan. So yeah, it is possible. It can be a very long term also. Next, interest rate determination. Now, on this residential mortgage loan, how will you actually pay the interest? Bank ke paas bahut sare options hote hai to determine that interest rate. So there are four categories. First one is a fixed rate. Fixed rate, as the name suggests, the interest rate will be fixed for the whole tenure. If I keep a fixed interest rate of say 7%, then till the loan is repaid, say 30 years, it will be 7% only. Second is variable rate or adjustable rate. As the name suggests, again, variable, so it will be varying, it won't be fixed. Interest rate is reset periodically based on some reference rate like the LIBOR. For example, LIBOR plus 4%. If this is the case. If LIBOR plus 4% bola hai, then in 2019, if the LIBOR is 2, then it will be 2 plus 4, which will be 6. If in 2020, if LIBOR becomes 3, then it will be 7. Or you never know, in 2030, LIBOR is just 1, then it will be 5. So basically, ye jo rate hai, it will keep on increasing or decreasing. So it is variable or adjustable. Third category is initial period fixed rate. Initial period fixed matlab starting mein hi sirf fixed hoga. So initial rate is fixed initially and adjusted to a new fixed or a variable rate. So let's say 30 years ka loan hai. 30 years mein we'll keep 2 years initial and 28 years later. 2 years ke liye I will keep fixed of say 12%. Now for the next 28 years I can either keep a new fixed rate of say 13% or I can keep a variable rate of LIBOR plus 9%. Kuch bhi chalega. So initially, thoda fixed, and then it can be variable or again a fixed rate. When fixed rate is adjusted to a new fixed rate. See, first you kept fixed of 12 and then you kept fixed of 13. If this is the case, then it is known as rollover or renegotiable mortgage. Rollover or renegotiable mortgage means that you are shifting from one fixed rate to other fixed rate. And the last is convertible rate. Convertible rate, so basically it is a fixed rate at the beginning and then a variable rate. Fixed to variable or variable to fixed. Anyhow, it is fine. Let's summarize these four again. Fixed rate ka matlab, it will be a fixed, say 4% or 5%, it will be fixed for the whole life. Then it was variable or adjustable rate, which is LIBOR plus something or a reference rate plus something. Then you had initial period fixed rate. For the start, it will be fixed and then it can be another fixed rate or it can be a variable rate. And last was convertible rate, fixed to variable or variable to fixed. Third characteristic is the amortization schedule. Now, amortization means that repayment of loan over the time period. How will it be repaid? So there are again four types. First one is the fully amortizing mortgage. Fully amortizing mortgage means principal and interest are included in all installments paid. Let's take one example. My loan is worth 10 million. Tenure is, say, 4 years. Year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4. I will consider these. It goes without saying that you have to pay interest definitely, but you will also pay some principal every year, thoda thoda repay karoge na. So let's consider two columns. This one is for principal. If it is a fully amortizing loan, then you might pay 2.5 million each towards principal, so that 10 million ka loan is repaid in 4 years, and definitely interest bhi bharenge. Either be interest. In the first year, tell me, in the first year, the outstanding loan will be 10 million from first year start till end. And of course, at the end of the first year, you will pay 2.5. So for the first year, outstanding balance is 10 million. So your interest will be on 10 million. Now for the second year, your outstanding balance is only 7.5 million. So the interest will be lesser. For the third year, outstanding is 5 million. Again, interest will be even lesser. And for the last year, for the fourth year, only 2.5 would be remaining as on the first day. And for that last year, only interest will be paid on 2.5 million. So, if it is a fully amortizing loan, basically, I mean to say, principal and interest both are included in the installments. Ye 2.5 ka principal plus this interest, whatever the amount is, that is known as installment. So, ye itna installment aap bharne wale ho. This is known as fully amortizing mortgage. Next is partly amortizing mortgage. Partly amortizing means that interest and some principal is paid by installments and rest of the principal is paid at the end. Like in our example, ab aisa hoga. Year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4. Principal itna rahega, 1 million, 1 million, 1 million, and at the end 7 million seedha. This is partially amortizing, means partially thoda thoda principal pay karenge, 1 each, and then at the end pura ka pura jo bacha hai 7 million wo pay karenge. Similarly, interest to pay karna hi hai on whatever is outstanding. This is known as partially amortizing or partly amortizing. Third is interest only mortgage. Interest only mortgage means no principal is to be repaid for some years. See, this is very important. No principal will be repaid for some years. Matlab, only interest has to be paid. Like in our example, we can keep principal 0, 0, 0. And maybe end mein you can pay 10. Or principal is 0, 0, 6 and 4. Anything is fine. So basically, for the start, principal nahi bharna hai, but after a while you will pay principal. This is known as interest only mortgage. Last one, very similar to that, इंटरेस्ट ओनली लाइफ टाइम मॉर्गेज. बेसिकली पूरे लाइफ में तुमको सिर्फ इंटरेस्ट भरना है, बट प्रिंसिपल विल बी पेड ओनली एट द एंड. लाइक इन दिस केस, ये वाला जो केस था 0-0-0 एंड एट द एंड यू आर पेइंग 10 का पूरा प्रिंसिपल. नाउ दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ओनली मॉर्गेज, बट वेरी स्पेसिफिकली यू कैन से इंटरेस्ट ऑन दी लाइफ टाइम मॉर्गेज. बेसिकली पूरे लाइफ में सिर्फ इंटरेस्ट भरना है, प्रिंसिपल नहीं भरना है. एंड एट दी एंड अ बलून पेमेंट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल विल बी मेड फुल 10 लाख का और फुल 10 मिलियन का. फोर्थ कैटेगरी इज प्री पेमेंट ऑप्शन एंड पेनल्टीज. वॉट डू यू मीन बाई प्री पेमेंट? सी वॉट इज प्री पेमेंट? वेन द बोरोअर पेज प्रिंसिपल इन एक्सेस ऑफ द शेड्यूल्ड रीपेमेंट. It means that you have repaid it earlier. Let's take an example. Again, we'll take that example of 10 million. And this is the schedule now. Schedule hai, you have to pay 2, 2, 2 and 4. This is how you are going to repay your principal. Now, this is the schedule. Okay. But actually what happened? Actually, you are repaying this loan over 3 years only. You repaid first year 2 million, second year 2 million, but at the end, third year pe hi tumne 6 million pay kar diya. Is this known as prepayment? Yes, definitely. Because you have paid your principal way before the schedule. Schedule ke hisab se, you had to pay 6 million. इन सच अ वे दैट ईयर 3 में 2 पे करते, ईयर 4 में 4 पे करते, बट यू हैव पेड होल 6 मिलियन इन ईयर 3 ओनली. दिस इज नोन एज प्री पेमेंट. वाई वुड वन प्री पे? सी दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. कोई प्री पे क्यों करेगा लोन? वाई वुड एनी वन पे दैट 4 मिलियन जो ईयर 4 में पे करना था उसको तुम ईयर 3 पे क्यों पे करोगे? देयर आर सो मेनी रीजंस. फर्स्ट वन, व्हेन द होम द कोलैटरल हाउस इज सोल्ड before the tenure of the loan. See, you purchased this house. 4 years ke liye tumko loan repay karna tha. You sold the house at year 3 end. If you sold the house at year 3 end, now you have so much money that you can definitely repay the loan in this year itself. And if you repay the loan in this year itself, you are saving 1 year's interest. Fourth year ka interest jo hai wo bach jayega na. So, first reason, when the home or the collateral asset is sold. Second, refinancing. This is important. New loan at lesser interest rate is available. So, you borrow new loan and you repay the old loan. Let's see one example. You borrowed 10 million at 7% interest for 20 years. After 6 years, home loans are available at 6% interest. You can borrow at 6 and prepay the old loan of 7%. 14 years before the maturity. Can I say, is it possible? Yes, definitely. 20 years ka loan hai. 6 years ho gaya. Now, 14 years left. Ye jo original loan tha, wo 7% interest pe tha. Ab tumko ek 6% interest pe loan mil raha hai. So, what can you do? Can you borrow at 6%? Yes. Out of that borrowing, can you repay that 7% ka loan? Yes. What is the benefit? 14 years baki hai na. 14 years 1% ka interest saving ho gaya. Earlier you would have paid 7%, but now you are paying only 6%. So interest saving ho gaya. That is what is the benefit of prepayment. However, there is one consequence. The bank may levy prepayment penalty for loss of interest. Don't you think bank will lose its opportunity to earn 1% extra? 7% usne lock kiya tha. To jo 1% ka loss hua na bank ko, it can levy a prepayment penalty. And this prepayment penalty is legal. Wo jabhi bhi aap loan ka document sign karoge, you will find a point for prepayment penalty. So in this case, 1% you might still have to pay to the bank. So it depends on contract to contract. Fourth is the rights of a lender in case of a foreclosure. First of all, let me remind you what was foreclosure? Bankruptcy. For example, 4 million ka loan hai. collateral is worth 5 million. Tell me one thing, you are a bank, 4 million ka loan tumne diya hai, collateral usne 5 million ka ghar rakha hai, and that guy becomes bankrupt. Is it good for you? Yes, because instead of 4 million, you are getting a home worth 5 million. Now, this process is known as foreclosure. However, there are two types. First one is a recourse loan. Second is a non-recourse loan. Recourse loan means that when a borrower defaults, the lender has claim over collateral asset as well as other assets of the borrower to recover the loan amount. Let's take an example. 4 million ka loan hai. Collateral is worth 3 million now. And the borrower has defaulted. Borrower made a default. Tell me one thing. You will sell this 3 million. Definitely you will sell this house for 3 million. So you got 3 million. Chalo. What about 1 million? 1 million kidhar se leke aane ga? That borrower has other assets as well. That borrower might have a car. He might have some cash in hand. He might have some bank balance. He might have gold. He might have jewelry. So many assets possible. This borrower will have to pay money out of those assets as well. This is what is recourse loan. This is very strict. So basically, that bank has a right over collateral asset as well as other assets of the borrower. But non-recourse loan, very easy. Non-recourse loan mein koi bahar ka asset nahi aayega. So when the borrower defaults, lender has claim over the collateral asset only. So if this example were a non-recourse loan, then ye jo 1 million hai wo usko milta hi nahi. 1 million kya ho jayega? Cancel ho jayega. Bank will get only 3 million. So what is a recourse loan? Bank can recover the amount by selling collateral as well as other assets of the borrower. What is non-recourse loan? Bank has right only over the collateral assets. Next topic, underwater mortgage or strategic default. You can default on a loan when the value of collateral asset declines. Let's understand how do you default. Vijay Mallya wagera ne kya kiya tha? Let's study that. Example, loan is equal to 10 million. Home value, which is the collateral, on the date of loan is 12 million. If after 5 years, home value is 7 million, it has fallen from 12 million to 7 million due to any reason. It can be any reason. Aaju baaju mein earthquake prone area hoga, ya fire lag gaya hoga, or any such case. Then you can default on repayment of loan. See, if you check loan to value ratio, earlier loan was 10 million and value of collateral was 12 million. Now, loan to value has become, say, after 5 years, you must have repaid thoda principal. So, I am considering 8 million outstanding loan and house value is 7 million now. Can I say it is a loss for the banker? Yes, because collateral ka value kam ho gaya. Can I say it is a profit for the borrower? Yes. Can the borrower willfully default? Yes. That is known as strategic default, the name of the concept, or underwater mortgage. Now, in this case, the borrower will definitely default. Borrower has 8 million with him right now. Ye numerator jo hai wo. Borrower ne agar default kiya, to bank ye 7 million ka ghar leke jayega. Okay, 1 million ka profit. This is known as strategic default. However, one negative consequence is that the borrower, jisko abhi hum log strategic defaulter bhi bolenge, will have a lower credit score and lower or reduced ability to borrow in future. See, once you have done something like this, ki ye 7 million ka ghar hai aur 8 million ka loan outstanding hai, to aap bhaag gaye. To theek hai, you made a profit of 1 million, no doubt. But you will have a low credit score or a low ability that the other bank or wherever you go next to borrow anything after some years, then that bank will not really be willing to lend it to you. So your future ability will be somewhat, you know, in danger. If the loan is a recourse loan, now this is a very good MCQ type question. Agar recourse loan hai to, let us recollect, recourse loan kya tha? If I make a default, bank kidhar se collect karegi paisa? First will be out of collateral, but also out of other assets. Tell me one thing, if your loan was a recourse loan, now will you really make a default when it is a recourse loan? If 8 million ka loan hai aur 7 million ka collateral hai, 7 million to bank ko mil jayega. What about that 1 million? Bank will really try to recover that 1 million from your other assets na. Recourse loan mein kya hota hai? Other assets se bhi paisa le sakta hai. So the last point says that if the loan is a recourse loan, then the default must not be made, since bank can recover the amount by selling collateral as well as other assets. So normal log kya karenge? They won't carry out this strategic default process if it is a recourse loan. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKeeda and subscribe to eKeeda.